Hello and welcome to this review of Oscar Bravo, Bravo India or Bahrain International Airport and Bahrain City by Justasia for X-Plane 11. If this is your first time on the channel and you like aviation and flight simulation and want to learn more about X-Plane 11 or just like to watch cinematic flight videos and other flight simulation related stuff, then start now by hitting subscribe and clicking the bell so you don't miss anything. Now, I actually consider doing a lot more reviews, so it would be awesome if you would comment on the video and tell me if this is something you would appreciate to see more of on the channel in the future. Just a short disclaimer before we start this review. I was approached by the developer Justasia, who asked me if I would be interested in doing a review of this scenery, which I kindly accepted. Now, of course, I'm not going to let this affect my opinion and this review, and the opinions shared in this review are my true and honest. So with that out of the way, let's get started. Bahrain International Airport serves as a main hub for Gulf Air, a major Middle Eastern airline and capable of serving almost 14 million people per year. The airport is only about 7 kilometers from the city of Manama, the capital of Bahrain, which is also modeled in this scenery. The scenery features high detailed representation of Bahrain International Airport, over 200 hand-placed custom objects, custom autogen for the entire Bahrain, highly detailed depiction of Manama with custom autogen, main landmarks are modeled, full custom HDR night lighting, full World Traffic 3 integration, plus custom ground routes, added static aircraft option for users who don't have World Traffic 3, SAM animated jetways, realistic ground poly for airport and surroundings, high resolution textures for terminals, loads of clutter to provide a realistic feel, ground traffic, up-to-date markings with recent construction, highly optimized and frame rates friendly compared to other scenery with similar detail. Now let's have a closer look. Installation is fairly simple, just a matter of drag and drop. I like that the scenery comes with an option to install ground routes for World Traffic 3 if you're using this plugin, and if you're not, then there's also an option to install static aircraft. Another good thing is that the scenery comes with SAM animated jetways. Of course, you need to download and install this great and free plugin, but then you also have animated jetways and stuff at the gates. As you can see, there is an appropriate amount of ground clutter, not too much so that it gets in the way, and it's representative of this particular area. What I particularly like about this scenery is that it includes a very large area. As you can see, it's not just the airport that is modeled. There's custom autogen for the surrounding area and the city, as you can see in the background. And there's also a few landmark buildings, as you can see. The Bahrain World Trade Center, buildings around the Bahrain Financial Harbor, and a few others. Night lighting is good and what you would expect, also in the city, as you can see here. Overall, the performance of the scenery package is really good. Now, that was the plus side of things. There are also things that could need a bit more of attention. One thing is the resolution of the ground textures around the airport and the surrounding areas, that is to the lower side. This gives the ground a bit of a blurry look when you get really close. I would also have liked textures of the buildings to be of high quality, but I'm also a bit picky. On the plus side though, this saves your VRAM and will probably work better also on lower end systems. Another thing that struck me was that I didn't see any PBR textures. What this means is that windows and metal or markings on the tarmac does not reflect light. This would have been a nice addition, and I believe this is one of Justasia's earlier sceneries and that they are now also including PBR texturing into their later and forthcoming sceneries. Now, there seems to be a bit of a general tree problem, meaning that there are trees in areas where they are not supposed to be, as here in the water, here where there were supposed to be a parking space, and here where there should have been buildings. Now, I'm not sure if this is my explain installation or not, but when I compare the screenshots from the explain.org store, I see the same trees in areas where they were not supposed to be. The 3D modeling seems a bit simplistic. It's effective, but personally I would have liked to see more details, such as air conditioning systems on the rooftops and so on. Also, cars in the parking spots and parking area in front of the terminal would have been a nice addition. Now, as mentioned, I really like the custom autogen, but unfortunately, as you can see, there are some areas where this awesome autogen is completely missing. This gives some areas a completely flat look at daytime, and in addition to that, HDR lights are completely missing at nights. This would be nice to see fixed in the next rendition of Bahrain. With that said, let's conclude this review. I do like the scenery. It's well optimized for good performance also on lower end systems. It's got really great autogen and it covers a large area. Still, I see some room for improvement, but if you're often flying in this area, then the scenery is definitely a must-have. Bahrain International Airport and City is available from the explain.org store for $25.50. If you like this video, please don't forget to comment, like and subscribe to the channel. Thank you so much for watching and see you very soon.